Hello everyone, welcome back to the Chemical Engineering and Aspen channel. And as you know that these days we are covering the module related to chemical reaction engineering, and in this regard we are bringing the lecture number 9 for our valuable viewers. At the end of lecture number 8, we have completed the chapter number 2 of the book Elements of Chemical Reaction Engineering by H. Scott Fogler, and now we are moving to the chapter number 3, and accordingly we have covered the first building block, the mole balance, in first two chapters, and now we are moving to the rate law building block number 2. So accordingly, first in this chapter, which is chapter number 3, we will review some important terms. We will then define the relative rate of reactions, units of rate constant and rate of reaction, and we will discuss today the power law in the chapter number 3. So let's review some important terms. Number 1 is homogeneous versus heterogeneous system. Now we know that if the reaction is proceeded in the same phase, like it's a completely gas phase system, liquid phase system, then we will say that it is a homogeneous reaction or homogeneous system in which the reaction is taking place. But if it's a multi-phase system, for example, the liquid reaction takes place in the presence of a solid catalyst, or gas phase reaction takes place in the presence of a solid catalyst, so accordingly there will be two phases involved in the system, and accordingly we will say that it is a heterogeneous system or heterogeneous reaction system. Second is reversible and irreversible. If the reaction proceeds in one direction, like A plus B produces C, we will say it's an irreversible reaction. But if C comes back to produce A and B, then we say it's an reversible reaction. Molecularity of the reaction, how many molecules which are involved in the participation of the reaction. If only one molecule is involved, we will say it's a unimolecular reaction. If two molecules are involved, we will say bimolecular reaction. And if three molecules are involved, we will say it is termolecular reaction. There are different examples like uranium decay, which is considered a unimolecular reaction. In bimolecular, we can say NO produces NO2, so it's a bimolecular reaction. Next one is the relative rate. Accordingly, the term is relative. It means that we have to compare one species with another. So accordingly, how fast one species is appearing or disappearing relative to the other species given in the system. For example, if we have two reactors in the system, A and B, then relative rate of A will be how fast it is disappearing with respect to B. Same goes with B, that how fast B is disappearing with respect to A. Or if C and D are the products, that how fast C is appearing with respect to D and how fast D is appearing with respect to C. So this is the relative rate. Then rate law, accordingly it is an algebraic equation that apply to a given reaction, and net rate will be sum of rate of reaction, which will be the total or the net rate. We will discuss it in length once we move to the next part. Accordingly, you can see that for the reactants it will be minus RA and minus RB. For the products it will be R of C and R of D. For reactants it is designated as negative R, while for products it is plus R. Now let's assume a reaction in which A and B species are reactants with stoichiometry coefficient as small a small b, and C and D are products with stoichiometry coefficient as C and D respectively. So first we need to specify which one of these is the limiting reactant. Obviously we are taking A as the limiting reactant, so making its stoichiometry coefficient as 1. And how we can do it? By dividing by A, which is small a, the stoichiometry coefficient. So accordingly, A plus B over A, B, C over A into C plus D over A into D. And accordingly, for this one, for this species, which is limiting reactant, the rate of reaction will be written as RA over minus A, or we can simply write it as minus RA over its stoichiometry coefficient. For reactant, it will be minus, for products, it will be plus. So accordingly, negative could be here or could be with the stoichiometry coefficient. The answer will remain the same. For B, RB over minus B or minus RB over B. And that is equal to, for this species, C, RC over C, and for species D, RD over D. So this is the overall definition of the relative rate of reaction. Now this shows, if we look at these two, that how fast this B is disappearing with respect to this A, or how fast the C is appearing with respect to this species D in the system. Now if we want to compute RB, how it will be calculated? RB is equal to B over A into RA. or minus RB is equal to minus RA B over A once we take these two terms. Now let's go to an example and solve it that we have been given A and B as reactant. 2 moles of A reacts with 1 mole of B to produce 3 moles of C, and the rate of disappearance of A is 10 mole per cubic decimeter per second. So accordingly, if we take this example, RA over minus RA is equal to RB over minus RB is equal to RC over C. So RA over minus 2A represents 2 here, B represents 1 here, C represents 3 here. So RA over minus 2 is equal to RB over minus 1 is equal to RC over 3. So accordingly, once we take RB, what it will be? So accordingly, minus RB is equal to minus RA over 2, and that will be 5 mole per cubic decimeter per second. And similarly, we take RC over 3 and RA over minus 2. So accordingly, it will be RC is equal to 3 over minus 2 or minus 3 over 2 into RA. So accordingly, it will be 15 mole per cubic decimeter per second. This is appearing in the system. Minus RB, B is disappearing from the system, A is disappearing from the system. So this is overall definition of relative rates of reaction, and we will use that example further in this chapter, and then we will be using it in the chapter number 6 as well. Now another important points, the limiting reactant is usually chosen as our basis for calculation. We have already seen that the rate of disappearance of A minus RA depends on temperature and concentration. Minus RA is a function of temperature because of the K, because once we write it is minus RA is equal to KCA. So that K is a function of temperature and then C, which is the concentration. So RA is a function of temperature and concentration. And you can see it over here as well that minus RA is equal to K into function of, it depends how many species are involved. CA, CB, C of C, and accordingly how many reactants are involved in the system. But accordingly, it is a function of specific reaction rate constant, which is only a function of temperature and concentration. Now, going to the law of mass action, that the rate of reaction increases with increasing concentration of reactants, because with the increase in concentration of reactants, the number of collisions increases. And with the increase in number of collisions, the rate of reaction increases. The algebraic equation that relates minus RA to the species concentration, this one is called as the rate law in the system. Minus R is equal to K, CA, CB, C of C, accordingly it depends on the system. The specific rate of reaction, also known as the rate constant, which is KA, applies to the specific species in the system. But look at this example. 1 mole of NaOH, 1 mole of HCl produces 1 mole of NaCl and 1 mole of water. All these species have one thing in common, that the stoichiometric coefficient remains the same. So for this system, for such systems, we can, instead of representing KNOH, KHCl, KNaCl, KH2O, we can say it simply as K. And this is written over here that it always refers to a particular species in the reaction and normally should be subscripted with respect to that species unless the stoichiometric coefficient is 1 for all species for which it is written as this. So we will say minus R is equal to KC of NaOH, C of HCl, only when the stoichiometric coefficient is 1 for all species. If it is not, then we will have to specify for which species we are writing the K, and obviously it will be for the limiting reactant. Now finally, moving on to the power law model, that the dependence of reaction rate minus RA on the concentration of the species is almost without exception determined by experimental observation. Obviously, you need experiments to run. You have to run multiple experiments to understand that how rate of reaction is depending on the concentrations. Because based on that, we have to define the different systems which we will be studying here. The order of reaction refers to the powers to which the concentrations are raised in the system. For example, we have two reactants, A and B, among which obviously A is the limiting reactant. So minus R is the rate of disappearance or the rate of reaction is equal to K of that limiting reactant, C of A raised to power alpha, C of B raised to power beta. Now the values of alpha and beta, these are determined experimentally, and based on these two values we define the system as elementary and non-elementary system. We will further discuss it in the upcoming lecture. Now the alpha is the order with respect to reactant A, beta is the order with respect to reactant B, and to determine the total order of the reaction, what we need to do, we need to simply add up. So alpha plus beta is equal to n, which is overall order of the reaction. So if we say the order of reaction is 2, we can say there are a number of situations like this could be 1 1 0 2 2 0, or maybe some decimals involved, and accordingly we say the system to be assigned as elementary or non-elementary. But this is the overall definition of the power law model, or this is the simple representation of the power law model, that it's an algebraic equation and simply written minus Ra, the rate of reaction is a function of, or it is simply calculated as the specific reaction rate constant and the concentration of the species which are involved as reactant in the system. But again, it is for the irreversible system. For the reversible system, concentration of the product species will also be included, but again we will go to that step by step. And finally, today's last point, units of rate of reaction and specific reaction rate constant. One thing which you always remember, the units of rate of reaction will always be mole per cubic decimeter per second or mole per volume per time, because obviously this cubic decimeter would be replaced by some other unit, or second could be replaced by minute, but it will always be mole per volume per time. For zero order system, we write rate law equation, which is an algebraic equation, as minus R is equal to K. For first order, KCA. For second order, KCA square. And for third order, KCA cube. Assuming that only one reactant, which is K, is involved in the system and it is converting to the product. Now, for this one, no CA is involved. Look at the zero order system. Minus R is equal to K. No CA is involved in the system. So unit of CA will be negligible. So now the units of K will be same as that of the minus RA. It will be mole per cubic decimeter per second. Coming on to the first order system, minus R is equal to KCA. CA is involved, which is mole per cubic decimeter. Now in this, you can see mole and cubic decimeter are covered. So what is remaining? 1 over second. So the unit of K will be 1 over second in the system. You can see this one over here. For the second order system, it is KCA square. So what it will be? Mole per cubic decimeter whole square. And here it is mole per cubic decimeter, single mole per cubic decimeter. So it means you have to multiply it with its reverse to get this system. So it will be cubic decimeter per mole per second. And for the third order system, minus R is equal to KCA cube. The units of CA will be mole per cubic decimeter cube. So the units of K, to make sure that the units on left hand side and right hand side identical, it will be cubic decimeter per mole whole square per second. So this is, even if you move to fourth order, fifth order, sixth order, you can see that this power will keep on increasing. So what is the generic formula for it? The generic formula will be K is equal to, the unit of K is equal to concentration raised to power 1 minus n over time. Now you can simply put values over here and you can get your answer. For example, n is equal to 0, 1 minus 0 will be 1, concentration over time. The units of concentration in mole per cubic decimeter, time is second. So you can see mole per cubic decimeter per second. Now for first order system, n is 1, 1 minus 1, 0, concentration raised to power 0 is 1. So 1 over time. So it means 1 over second, and you can get the unit over here. And similarly for second order, for third order and for higher orders, you can get the same. So that's it from today's lecture. Thank you so much. I hope you have understood the lecture. And if you have any queries, please write in the comment box so I will be able to answer your queries. So that's it from this video. Thank you so much. Please do watch, like, share the video and subscribe to the channel. Also click on the bell icon to get all updates related to this channel. Till then, it's goodbye. Stay tuned for more exciting videos on this channel.